Hey everybody, today I'm presenting RotoFury and TrackerFury. These tools will use motion vectors to drive trackers and rotos. Let's take a look at an example here. These rotos here, I draw them just on the first frame, and then I let the motion vectors drive the points of the shapes to do the roto for me. You can get pretty interesting results. Of course, depends on the quality of your motion vectors, but I think that has a huge potential to save a lot of time. I'm using smart vectors, but you can use really a vector generator, which will be, you know, worse. But you can also use Copycat with Raft. You can use any AI tool that will create motion vectors for you. You can even use 3D passes motion vectors. So really, you just need to feed the motion vector and then you start to drawing your shapes and the tool will track it for you. So let's take a look. Here I have a pre-render smart vector to work faster. And then you just plug it to the motion vector and say here the channel that you want to use. For the smart vector, I recommend using smart vector F01, V01 channel. If you are using vector generator or regular motion vectors, use the forward channel. Then you need to just set, you know, the frame range to track, and the update interval is the keyframe interval. So if you want keyframes every 10 frames, 5 frames, 3 frames, you just set this up to get this updated. So let's say every 5 frames, and then you need to, of course, create a roto shape. I will draw here a shape for this, for the nose, and basically it will track each point with the motion vector that is on that region. I will track just on the selected shape. You can track all shapes, but for this one, just selected shape, and I will execute from frame 1 to 50. So the speed here depends on the amount of points, because each point has to be tracked using the underlying motion vector. But you know, it's the speed's not so bad. Unless you have tons of points, it will get slow, but it is what it is. And if you have the pre-render motion vector, it will be even faster. Okay, so let's check the result here. Not bad, right? And this is a regular roto, so if you can, at any time, you can come here and say, hey, let's fix this. And then you can continue, like from frame 26 to 50 or something. You know, you can also do something more interactive. And let's say you want to draw something here, and then you can you need to make adjustments over time. You can just use these two buttons, the previews and next, so you can create the next keyframe 5 frames forward. Then you can come here and make adjustments, and then you can do the next 5 frames or something, and you can go backward as well. Let's say I want 10 frames backward. If you want, you can reduce the update interval and say, let's go from frame 26 to 15. You can go backward using the execution button as well. Just need to invert the order here. So now I have keyframes every 2 frames going backwards. So this is RotoFury. Basically, that's it. So TrackerFury will extract trackers from motion vectors. You know, you can like drop your trackers where you want to track. Let's put one on background. So I have 4 trackers here. You plug your motion vector pass. I have pre-render smart vector here. And then you set the frame start and end. And then you can execute. Let's see. The beauty of this is that this is still a tracker. So also, like with the roto, you can at any point, let's say you started here and maybe this get lost sometimes. Maybe this should be on the middle of the eye. So you can, you know, you can make an adjustment and then you can refine just the selected tracker from this frame to the end. Or maybe you can track a little bit and then you stop and then you continue with the motion vector if you want. So it's, you can mix and match tracking motion vectors, and you can try to use this for your advantage to improve your tracking. So it's not that motion vectors would be better than regular tracking, but if you have motion vectors, the tracking will be free. Of course, this depends on the quality of your motion vector. You can get really fast results, and you can use these trackers to do other stuff. You can stabilize, you can something that you cannot do with the motion vector pass itself or using the smart vector tools, which is, you know, pretty fun. But if you have any suggestions or any UI improvement suggestions, or if you find any bug or issue, please let me know. Thanks for watching.